You're watching News Channel 5 at 6.
More trouble for Laurentian Aerospace. The company can't do business in Plattsburgh or anywhere else in New York State. Looking for Laurentian becoming ever more difficult. Good evening, I'm George Mallet.
And I'm Stephanie Gorin. Laurentian Aerospace is the project the North Country has been waiting for, an airplane maintenance facility that would bring hundreds of good-paying jobs to the region.
Tonight, we're sorry to say there's been yet another blow to the project's progress. News Channel 5's Bridget Shanahan is here now with more on her investigation.
Well, thanks, George. Everyone wants to see Laurentian happen. A project this big would generate jobs and spur the economy on both sides of the lake. However, as we continue to dig deeper into the company and its financing, we uncovered another problem. Laurentian isn't even licensed to do business in New York and hasn't been able to do business in the Empire State for more than a year.
It is official. You know, we've got money changing hands and we've got contracts signed.
That's Laurentian's CEO announcing the company has the funding to move forward with the project. That was on March 1st, 2011. By April of that same year, just 8 weeks after that announcement, New York's Department of State, one of the agencies that keeps an eye on businesses, dissolved Laurentian Aerospace. The problem? The firm, which is supposed to build a $200 million airplane maintenance facility in Plattsburgh, can't pay $1,650 in corporate taxes.
It's not a big amount of money compared to the amount of money they're talking about, so I would be concerned if they didn't pay up on that and move forward.
By mid-May last year, Laurentian announced they were having problems with their financing and the project was being put on hold. News Channel 5 has been investigating Laurentian's finances for months. We visited with lawmakers, traveled to Albany, to the Department of State and other agencies to get answers. The experts we talked to say you cannot do business if you are not incorporated. And even though it is a pretty easy fix to get the license back, those who want to see Laurentian happen have concerns.
Everybody's hopeful.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think anybody wants to give up on a project. There was so much excitement with it, though, but, you know, your excitement dims after several years and you keep waiting for it.
Now, you may remember months ago we checked to see if Laurentian had building permits and other paperwork to start construction in the town of Plattsburgh. Checked again today, still no sign of those permits, Steph and George.
And Bridget, you've been digging on this for a while. What else can you tell us?
Well, when we uncovered that the company was dissolved, we started looking into more of the financing for the project. And there are some things that may actually surprise you, both about the public funds and private forces behind Laurentian. We're putting the finishing touches on these new reports and should have them out sometime soon for you guys, hopefully next week. And I do want to say that we did try and speak with Laurentian officials about these latest developments, but our calls went unreturned.
All right. Thanks. We'll stay tuned.